Jailbreak your 3.1.3 Apple device and get mobile internet on your Wi-Fi only iPad. That's right, 2-for-1 day here at App Judgment. And it's free. This episode of App Judgment is brought to you by Gamefly. Welcome to App Judgment, your premier source for mobile application reviews. I'm Mauricio Balvanera. So you got yourself the Wi-Fi only iPad and now you're thinking, damn it, should have waited for that 3G version. Well, you should have, but I have a fix for you today, so let's get ready to go MacGyver. All you need is one iPhone, 3G or 3GS will do fine, running OS 3.1.2 or 3.1.3, one sync cable, white, one computer running Windows or OS 10 with iTunes, the internet, preferably net neutral, and one piece of gum, the bubble kind. We're gonna start off by jailbreaking our phone. Jailbreaking is the process that allows iPhone and iPod Touch and even iPad users to run unofficial code on their devices by bypassing Apple's official distribution. Now, we've done this before back in episode 44, but the iPhone has since grown up to a slightly new operating system, version 3.1.3. As of now, Black Rain, the jailbreaking software we used in that episode, is not compatible with OS 3.1.3 and is still plagued with tethering reboots on some phones. Go Google it, it's a can of worms you don't really need to get into right now. Luckily, there's an alternative solution called Spirit. Head over to spiritjb.com and download the software. I happen to be running OS 10, but again, this will work on your Windows machine. Connect your iPhone to your computer and back up. This is crucial in case anything goes wrong. Then take 1 second to ponder whether or not you really want to do this, because if you jailbreak, you're voiding your warranty and potentially rendering your phone unusable. Most software restores will fix any bad installs, but in that really rare case that something goes wrong, don't blame me, blame Eileen.
What?
Also keep in mind that if you've jailbroken your phone using a tethered method like Black Rain, you'll have to first restore your phone before you run Spirit. Do not upgrade if you currently use an unlock on your iPhone 3G or 3GS. Keep in mind, Spirit will also make it impossible to unlock your phone in the future, that is, allow the use of a carrier other than AT&T, as Spirit will upgrade your phone's baseband, and that kind of sucks if you care. And remember, Spirit is not a carrier unlock, it's just a jailbreaker. So let's jailbreak. After you finish backing up, run Spirit and click jailbreak. Now pull out that piece of gum and enjoy your time with it. Okay, we're done. Seriously, that's it. Jailbreak complete. I don't even know why you needed me here for that. Oh, I know why. Because we're gonna take your newly warranty voided phone and give this Wi-Fi only iPad internet anywhere your phone is. Right after this. Gamefly is the largest online video game rental service and offers you a choice from over 7,000 new and classic titles across all consoles and handhelds. With plans starting at $15.95 a month, Gamefly members can rent 1 to 4 games at a time and keep them for as long as they'd like. There are no late fees, no due dates, and shipping is always free. Once you've done playing the game, send it back and Gamefly will send you the next available game on your list. If you really like the game you're playing, click Keep It on the Gamefly website and the game is yours at a discounted price. App Judgment fans get a 15-day free trial when they go to www.gamefly.com/app. Judgment. All right, onward to tethering your iPad. Okay, head over to the newly installed City app. It's on here somewhere. No, there it is. Okay, search for and install MyWi, spelled M-Y-W-I. I'm downloading and using Rock to install MyWi since my serial number already lives in there from our previous install in episode 104. Take a look at that episode for more info on MyWi as well as info on other tethering apps I didn't like as much. MyWi is available now for $9.99 and comes with a free 10-day trial if you download it on Rock. MyWi is going to allow you to send out a Wi-Fi signal using your phone's internet. You're essentially creating your own personal and portable hotspot. The next step is pretty obvious. Simply connect your iPad to the network you've just created and presto, 3G internet without 3G iPad pricing or service plan. Now keep in mind, it's not all sugar and spice. Using your phone's 3G means a possible soft cap on data from AT&T if they see you suddenly using something like 4 times the amount of traffic or whatever. So make sure you're not auto-updating podcasts or movies on your iPad. My less than scientific speed test gave me an average of 2.98 megabits per second. Your results may vary. Battery drainage on your phone is crazy fast when tethering, so keep a charger handy. Now, another downside is that you're jailbreaking your phone, so it's up to you to decide whether a slightly sluggish phone performance and a voided warranty is worth the tether. But you have to admit, the ability to access the internet with your iPad anywhere is a pretty big bonus, and the gloat factor around iPad 3G owners is priceless. Another great thing about a portable hotspot? Automatic announcements that you've just arrived.
These are French tips.
Do you like it? Yeah, I've just never seen these colors like that. And you know, Mal's network just checked in.
Oh God! Thank God for that early warning system.
Let's get out of here.
Where is everyone? Did you buy an iPad 3G? Email us your regrets at appjudgment@revision3.com or hit me up personally at twitter.com/MalBrownCow. You can also find us on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and revision3.com/appjudgment. Practice safe jailbreaking.